Hi everyone. Today's material segment is going to be on something that as a cosplayer I'm fairly certain you will eventually get to use, and that's craft foam. If you buy these in the store, sometimes they're called foamies, and sometimes they're also called fun foam. Usually you'll find them in the kids section. They have these nice colorful little labels on them. And they come in a couple of different thicknesses. This particular one is 2 millimeters thick. This particular one, the white, is 3 millimeters thick, and it will have the thickness right there on the label. And the thickest that you can usually buy it in retail stores, is 6 millimeters thick. And this is fairly thick, as you can see here on the side. I will hold all of these up together next to each other so you can actually see the difference in thickness. And as you can see there, the difference is pretty marked when you actually go from 3 millimeters to 6 millimeters. Fun foam is one of the most versatile things you can use in cosplay. You can use it for armor, for accessories, for all sorts of different things, including weapons, if you'd like to do that, because some conventions are getting a little bit more strict on their weapons policies. Usually, fun foam is used whenever you need something flexible, because that's its greatest strength. It's very flexible. It can be rolled into cylindrical shapes, like so. You can cut it using pretty much any cutting device you prefer. You can use scissors, you can use an X-Acto knife, you can use straight blade scissors. For the 6 millimeter thick ones, you'll probably want to use an X-Acto knife when cutting because it can be a little difficult to get a clean edge with scissors just because it's so thick. When using fun foam for things that require a little bit more thickness or a little bit more rigidity, you can actually coat it with a couple of different substances. This is called gesso. This is usually used as a primer, especially if you need to paint the fun foam for any reason, because fun foam is, of course, porous, which means it's filled with a bunch of tiny holes that you have to cover up before you paint it. This is basically a goopy white substance. You can tell mine is a little bit dry, it hasn't been used in a while. So it looks like this. You can coat your fun foam with it, and if you use multiple layers, you can give it a little bit more structure. Gesso isn't generally used to make something rigid. It's mostly just used to make something smoother, and it can be used to give a little bit more in the way of body to your fun foam. And I have made a mess. If you want it harder, you can use something called hard coat Mod Podge. You've probably seen Mod Podge before in hobby stores. There's a few different kinds. This one happens to be the one that's supposed to make it hard. If you read the back, it says that it has to cure for 4 weeks, and it's supposed to be as hard as wood when you do it. I have actually tried using this on fun foam, and it does make it harder. It just doesn't exactly make it as hard as wood, unfortunately. But those are a couple of things that you can use to coat your fun foam if you would like to make it a little more rigid or to give it a little bit more structure when you're using it for things that require it, such as this. This is an example of something you can do with fun foam. These are the halves to an armored corset. This is for Athena from Saint Seiya. This comes in two halves. This is entirely made of fun foam. You can see on the back where I had to kind of piece it together. There is a seam there, unfortunately, and that is something you have to worry about when using fun foam, is that generally, unfortunately, the pieces themselves that they come in, the sheets, are fairly small. This is about the largest retail sheet you can get, and this is 11 by 17. The smaller 6 millimeter sheets only come in half sizes. This is only half as large as a normal sheet. So unfortunately, if you want to use the thicker foam for something like this, you end up having to take the pieces and you have to glue them together on an edge, usually with hot glue, so that you get a full sheet. Unfortunately, that does mean you have a seam, but it can't really be helped. So that is something to think about. It's definitely something where you need to plan your seam if you're going to have one. But as you can see, this is pretty thick. This was using one thickness of 6 millimeter foam and one thickness of the 3 millimeter foam for a total of 9 millimeters thick. I did coat it in gesso, and then you can spray paint it, as you can see. If you spray paint fun foam without coating it first, it can eat away the fun foam. It tends to be a rather messy process, so it's much easier to make sure that you prime it first You can glue things to it if you prefer. You don't necessarily have to use glue that's meant for foam. You can use basically any type of normal crafting glue, including good old tacky glue, and you can just adhere it to the surface as you wish. Now this is, of course, an example of armor that you can use. People also use it as adornments on weapons. And this is entirely made of foam, at least the decoration part is here. This was made using 3mm fun foam. This is Umi Ryuzaki's sword from Magic Knight Rayearth. And as you can see, it can be used to make pretty intricate designs. You can trace on it with pen to make certain effects if you'd like. You can glue it in layers, which if you can see sideways, this does actually have several layers to it. And that does give it a certain thickness on the sides, which is helpful if you're trying to make it somewhat rigid. When making foam weapons like this, it can be helpful to have a rigid core to start with, which is what the blade is made of. There is a difference between fun foam and foam board. They are not actually the same thing. This is foam board. It's hard. And it does not bend. It's very rigid. If I were to try and bend this, it would crack in the middle, which is something else you actually have to worry about. Foam board is rigid. Fun foam is, of course, not. So it's better to start with a rigid core if you're going to use it for weapons, and then put the fun foam over it to get the design that you would like. Fun foam will never actually get entirely rigid unless you use a substance on it that will make it entirely rigid. For example, fiberglass. You can fiberglass over fun foam as long as you coat it first. You can also use putties, such as Bondo, and you can also coat it in paper mache if you would prefer. And you can cover it entirely in paper mache, and that will make it rigid as well. You can use paper clay if you don't actually want to get down and messy and make the paper mache yourself. But no matter what you use, only if you use something that becomes rigid itself will fun foam become rigid. Otherwise, no matter what you do to it, it will still retain some flexibility, which may be good or bad, depending on what you want to do with your end product. And so that is a basic overview of fun foam. The sheets themselves are fairly inexpensive. You can purchase them at any major hobby store, such as Michael's, Joann's, Hobby Lobby. Some places may have entirely different mom-and-pop craft stores as well. They're usually about $1.29 to $2 a sheet for the large sheets. If you watch in your local ads, they usually go on sale, and they usually have a cycle, so it's good to watch for that. The other thing you can do with fun foam, if you want to get it in large quantity, is that they do sell it in rolls. This is a 60-inch roll. These are usually about $8 at your local hobby store. These are only sold in the 3mm thickness. You don't really have a choice with these, but it does give you a much larger area on which to work if you want to make something such as an armor-based, a breastplate, if you like, with fun foam. Bear in mind that, again, this is very thin, very flexible stuff, so if you do want to make armor with large pieces like this, you need to either layer it by gluing the layers together, or you need to coat it in something that will become rigid later. You can also use plaster, incidentally, strips of plaster, if you would like to make something rigid out of fun foam. I do not recommend that you use plaster strips on armor, simply because they become so rigid that you cannot move in it, and it will break. And after working so hard on something you've made out of fun foam, you definitely don't want to suddenly break it. And that's our overview of fun foam.